All right, I got to jump in with both feet here. Bob, we've been hearing more and more of the economic pundit, the pundits, the whiz kids behind the scenes. They're all starting to finally say, you know what, maybe we should get out of all this paper stuff and start getting into commodities. But don't put any more than 10% of your portfolio in commodities. Yes, you can buy a little silver, a little gold. You might want to consider, you know, some agricultural products or stuff like that. But not more than 10% of your portfolio. Why are they just basically focusing on that 10% issue, Bob? Are they just blowing smoke at everybody?
Yes, and it's called vested interest. If they told everybody to get out of 50 or 60 or 70 or 80% of their stocks, they wouldn't have a market. And so they have to keep the game up, this make-believe game that they're in. And people outside the box like myself who have been able to predict everything. It's simple because you know what they're going to do. They're going to do the wrong thing or what is ever right for themselves. And so that's why they won't have you go into commodities or gold and silver as precious metals. And they never have, and they never will, because they have that vested interest. I mean, when I was on Wall Street, I was tolerated. I mean, I was an anachronism. I was something that to be looked and laughed at.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the only thing is I lasted 28 years as a broker, and most of them didn't. I own my own firm.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the reason why. And, you know, Wall Street and the Federal Reserve and our government, one of the big things that they have created for themselves is there's no longer any confidence, there's no trust, and there's fear. And when you get that, you can't get people to do, excuse me, most anything.
Mm-hmm.
And just as a good example is the latest $30 billion lifeline that they threw to AIG, the international insurance company, which is also a money laundering operation for the CIA and has been since the OSS was in on it during the Second World War. And what they did, and it's starting to come out now, you'll read about it this week, they used AIG as a secret conduit to give money to banks and brokerage firms in the United States and in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
And because they didn't want to tell anybody what they were doing. This continual lying and subterfuge. And the only reason the information came out is somebody stole memos from AIG and exposed them to the media and all of the media, so the media couldn't say, well, we're not going to print that because we don't believe it. They were forced to. And this is the kind of government that we have. And it just gets worse and worse. And now we've reached a point in the marketplace where it's going to take a long time to get any confidence. Every day people are liquidating not only their stocks and their bonds, but particularly stocks, not only in their portfolios, but in their retirement accounts, and they're cashing in their life insurance policy so they can get the cash out of it. They're getting rid of their annuities because all of these are exposed to the market.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And if the market goes to 4,000 in the Dow, which I think is pretty easy, and I think we're going to be lucky if it stops there, well, all these entities are going to have lost 60, 70, 80% of the invested funds that they have in these annuities, insurance policies, portfolios, etc.
Well, the market will be opening in just a matter of a couple of minutes at this point, and it'll be interesting to see how things are going to go. Of course, the futures and Dow are down right now by about 100 points. The Dow is going to open, like I said, in just about a minute from now, and they're at 6626.94. And I can't help. I'm going to get out my little whistle. Anyway.
They tried to knock gold down considerably this morning, but they were unsuccessful, and I think that's what would happen.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to scratch my head last week. I mean, of course, gold about a week ago topped the $1,000 an ounce mark. Just briefly, it just went right over and went back down, and then it dropped down to like 910 this past week. Now today it's sitting at about 938. When we get back from this break, we're going to talk to Ted Anderson and get his take on what the heck is going on with this bouncing ball price of gold and silver. try to figure out, make some sense of it. But it doesn't make any difference, folks. We all know what's coming. We all know that the dollar's going to tank. I don't know what it's going to take for everybody to start getting themselves ready for it. We're talking.